I went into this vast 700 acres of space called the Yellow Black Moon. I was there. A space that some people back in the day would refer to as UC. Because the university in 1948 started as the University College of the West Indies. So it was then the UCII. Around 1962 became the UII. And here I am on the Mona campus, someone who would not have benefited from having my parents attend a university. The modern term that they use for this now is first generation student. So here am I. Not with the support system of some of parents or family members who would have gone to university. But I went into the UII. And immediately I knew I needed to find friends, whether any persons in my, it was then natural sciences, in my chemistry classes, or for the persons who I met in the Hall of Residence, who helped me to feel comfortable. Who, recognizing that we were persons from sometimes low socioeconomic background, and we needed to come together to make it happen. We needed to come together to run a boat. Anybody understand the run a boat mentality? Yeah, because survival is important within that space. But in doing so, in the UII, I was learning the importance of teamwork. I was learning the importance of working with others from various backgrounds. I was learning the importance of just each one supporting each other on the road to success. So Prendergast speaks of promoting a culture of success. And there are enough first-class degrees for each of you seated here. But the fact of the matter is that do not feel that by helping someone else, it will lessen your chance to get there. Right? I am a proud UII Pelican because I understand that partnership is important in arriving at success. That supporting each other is a part of that success. And so here I am at UII. And I got involved because I recognized rather early that though the academics are important, learning is happening everywhere. And so I got myself engaged in corporate activity, right? And though I was introduced to football earlier, I became a member of the Urbanol team. And before I knew it, I was captain of the Urbanol football team. And before I knew it, I was playing football for the UII, playing with persons who have gone on to become national players. I wasn't a track star at high school. I was no Usain Bolt or Michael O'Hara. But then I ended up representing the UII in the country, being a 100 meter champion for my Hall of Residence, champion for my Hall of Residence, right? And winning medals at Sports Day. You too will get a chance to participate in Sports Day. And before I knew it, there's something called Intercampus Games. And so in Intercampus Games, it's held by annually. And so 1 year it's in St. Augustine, 2 years later, it's in Cavill, and 2 years further, it's at Mona. And so an opportunity presents itself for me to travel to represent the UII in sports. That's the part of being a UII editor. And before I knew it, I was involved in other things, and I became block representative, and then I became hall chairman. I ran for guild president, and I lost that race by 3 votes. I was a little volunteer, but, you know, especially knowing that there are persons who, oh, he already won. I'm not going on to vote. But in all of this, I am learning leadership. Leadership. Leadership at various levels. And sometime when I was hall chairman, the university entered in a partnership with Florida State University. And so we were sending some students to FSU, foreign, you know, not little foreign like the world of the Barbie, but big foreign like going to the USA. And here I am, a poor little country boy who at that point in time never even had a passport. We can't discover our own fearing this document because an opportunity was about to present itself. So my first time of traveling was courtesy of the UWI, because as a student, I became engaged, I became involved, and the leadership of the institution would have seen in me something who said, I would like for you to represent the UWI at Florida State University. And so, my first trip out of Japan, at the expense of the UWI. So, I am a UWI pelican. I'm proud of the UWI pelican because the institution moved me, prepared me for leadership. Not just here in Jamaica, but in the global space. I fast forward many years later, when I was chosen among 20 persons in the world to go to Europe to represent the university. This is in an era of science and technology. No, because I would have pursued chemistry and food chemistry and I don't need that my first degree. And here I am in Holland or the Netherlands, among 20 persons from all over the world, China, Russia, and so on, engaging in an era of chemistry. And among the 20, I became valedictorian, representing not just UWI, but representing Jamaica in that scenario. I am a proud UWI pelican because I understand clearly the experiences that I had in that space and how those have prepared me for the world at large. I'm a proud UWI pelican because in all of this, I learned how to relate to persons from different backgrounds. I understood the value of respect. I understand the value of integrity. I understand what it means to be excellent at what you do. And this has not come about because I am bright. You know, my people in high school and so on may say that. But no, because understanding the value of hard work and making use of the opportunities as they present to you. The UWI is an important space that will present you opportunities after opportunities after opportunities. What we call on you to do is to grasp those opportunities. It's not sufficient to say I'm a student leader or a leader if it's not ethical leadership. I am a proud UWI pelican because I understand what ethical leadership is all about. And so, yeah, I have benefited from several levels of leadership. I was hall chair, I became resident advisor, I became student services and development manager, and now I am proud to say I'm serving as director of the Office of Student Services and Development for this same institution that gave me my formative higher education. And for that, I am proud. I am proud that I got married in the UWI chapel. Because that is an important experience in my life. I continue to benefit from the joys of marital bliss, having engaged in that process in the UWI chapel. I am a proud UWI pelican. For the reasons I've articulated and many more, I have been able to gain so many rich experiences. And as I share, it's not to boast, but it's to say to you, because I haven't even begun to get deeper into so many of it. I'm just giving you a glimpse into an experience, a personal experience, a young country boy who knows what poverty is. Right? To have gone to the UWI, a space that presented me with a glorious opportunity to advance in many, many ways. and I seized the opportunities inside the classroom and outside of the classroom in an effort to attain success. I am proud. You two who are seated here this morning can tell fantastic stories. Stories more impactful than the few that I've shared. But this is the start of an important journey. And it is critical that this foundation over the next few weeks, over the next year, is laid in such a way that you will seize every single moment that presents themselves to you. I am proud of the Bible, and there are many standing around here who would be willing to say that to you today. And as you journey, as you start your journey with this first step, I ask of you that you embrace the core values that have been articulated to you over and over again. I ask of you that you seize the moment inside the classroom, you seize the moments outside of the classroom, and you purpose in your heart that regardless of the challenges faced in that space, in this space, you will not speak ill of this new institution, because a part of being a proud UW Pelican is knowing and recognizing that this is not an institution without its challenges, but the fact of the matter is that if we hold hands together, administration and students, together, we can all be proud of the space.